President Marcos and the visiting Emir of Qatar tackle improving bilateral relations in Malacañang. Let's get details now from Pia Gutierrez, who is there. Pia, good afternoon. Over to you.
Hi, Sally. Good afternoon. Yes, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on Monday welcomed the Emir of Qatar, Sheikh Tamim Bin Hamad Al Thani, to Malacañang. The Emir arrived in Malacañang at around 9:30 in the morning, where he was given arrival honors. The Qatari leader is embarking on a two-day state visit to the Philippines from April 21 to 22. And during their bilateral meeting, President Marcos Jr. said that he hoped that the visit will result in stronger collaboration in common fields of interest between Qatar and the Philippines, as well as open opportunities to improve and strengthen bilateral relations at the commercial level, at the government-to-government level, and finally at the people-to-people level. Meanwhile, the Emir said that the Philippines is an important partner for Qatar in many fields, especially in trade and economic cooperation, and that they aspire to improve these relations to increase communication between the private sector and both countries. He also praised the Filipino community in Qatar for their effective contribution to the development and progress of their country. Meanwhile, Sandy, a total of 9 bilateral agreements were signed during the visit, including an agreement to waive visa requirements for holders of diplomatic and special or official passports, as well as MOUs of cooperation on sports, youth in combating human trafficking, on climate change, tourism and business events, and on mutual recognition of seafarer certificates. There were also MOUs signed between the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry and the Qatar Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and between the Davao City Chamber of Commerce and Industry and the Qatar Chamber of Commerce and Industry. After the meeting, Stanley, a state banquet was held at the ceremonial hall of Malacañang in honor of the visiting Qatari leader. Stanley?
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Pia Gutierrez. The Philippine Energy Regulatory Commission expecting an improvement in the country's power supply situation. Luzon and Visayas were repeatedly placed under red and yellow alerts last week due to forced outages and weak capacity of power plants. The ERC says power transmission services have been restored over the weekend, pushing them to lift all alerts on Monday.
Wala po tayong alerto kasi over the weekend hanggang kagabi ng alas 10, nakabalik na po yung malalaki nating planta online. So medyo makakahinga po tayo ng konti. Sana lang po walang mangyari ulit na aberya. So both Luzon, actually all grids natin, Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao, normal po ang ating supply situation. By tomorrow, meron pa rin nakaschedule na papasok. Yung mga matatagalan po talaga yung mga hydro plants natin. Kasi mag-aabang talaga yun ng tubig.
The Energy Department also ruling out sabotage in the recent power woes in the country. It says the incidents were mainly due to the high electricity demand in the country amid the extreme heat. Palestinian authorities recover bodies at a hospital in Khan Yunis in southern Gaza weeks after the withdrawal of Israeli forces. The Palestinian Civil Emergency Service said at least 60 bodies were recovered from the Nasser Hospital compound Sunday. A total of 210 bodies have been dug up there since last Friday. Authorities said around 2,000 people remain missing in Khan Yunis and are believed to be buried under the rubble. The city endured an intense Israeli offensive in recent months. Across Gaza, more than 34,000 people have died in Israel's assault.